मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम नारायण लाइव क्लासेस की डिस्कशन पे। नारायण लाइव क्लासेस की डिस्कशन क्लास 9 सोशल स्टडीज, टॉपिक इज एटमॉस्फेयर, असाइनमेंट 3। असाइनमेंट 3, सो यू नो वेरी वेल दैट यस्टरडे वी हैव लर्नड अबाउट द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द एटमॉस्फेयर। स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द एटमॉस्फेयर दैट इज ए होमोस्फीयर, हेट्रोस्फीयर, स्ट्राटोस्फीयर, ट्रोपोस्फीयर, मेसोस्फीयर, थर्मोस्फीयर, एक्सोस्फीयर, ऑल दीज थिंग्स वी हैव लर्न्ड यस्टरडे। सो टुडे वी विल लर्न अबाउट द असाइनमेंट इज बेस्ड अपॉन द प्लैनेटरी विंड्स, द प्लैनेटरी विंड्स एंड द मूवमेंट ऑफ द एयर इन द वर्ल्ड। द एयर विल बी कंटिन्यूअसली मूविंग, बेस्ड अपॉन दैट द असाइनमेंट हैज बीन डिजाइंड। So what happens actually is when the temperature is very high, when it is very high temperature, usually the gases in the atmosphere also gets heated up and they expand. This expanded air will become light and the lighter air tends to move up. So children, that means what happens when the temperature is very high, usually the pressure will decrease because it expands, no? Expands means it is not compressed. So the pressure will decrease. The pressure and the temperature both are inversely related or reciprocal to each other. Right, children? So the first question is that only when the temperature increases, the pressure, what happens to the pressure? The pressure decreases. That is the right option. Pressure decreases. And second thing is the equator has low pressure area. The equator or equatorial regions have low pressure areas. Why do the equator has the low pressure area? Because the temperature is very high, no? When the temperature is very high, the air expands and automatically low pressure occurs in that particular area. So the low pressure is there near the equator because of the high temperature. Due to this high temperature, this equator has the highest lowest amount of the pressure. Low pressure is located there. Okay. And so what happens? Always the water will be flowing from higher areas to the lower areas, no? In the same manner, even the air also will be moving from high pressure areas to low pressure areas. So the air moving from high pressure areas to low pressure areas, we call that air as the wind. What do we call that as? Wind. So that is the next question is that only. What is that? What is the air that is moving from high pressure areas to low pressure areas called as? That is called as the wind, right? And this particular area where the low pressure winds and the high pressure winds will be continuously transcending, we call that area where low pressure is there, we call that area as the equatorial region. So this equatorial region is also known as the intertropical convergence zone. Why it is called as the intertropical convergence zone? See here, children, that is in the world, that is in the globe itself, near the equator, what happens? These are the tropics. So from these tropics, the winds will be moving like this. See here. Like this southeast direction, and here also that is northeast direction. So like this, what is happening? Both are meeting here. So we call this particular phenomena as the intertropical convergence zone. ITCZ. So, the answer is ITCZ. What is ITCZ? ITCZ means Intertropical Convergence Zone. That is the answer for this question. Okay.
ourselves soon.
And children, not only that you have these areas, that means equatorial regions or the polar regions, they'll be having a continuous flow of the air. As the air becomes a lighter air, this lighter air will move up. When the air goes up, what happens? It gets the moisture. It gets the moisture. That means it gets coolness. When it gets coolness, automatically it is compressed and it becomes dense. So this denser air tends to move down. That means they will start moving down, or they will start descending down. They will start descending, or they will start moving down. Right, children? So the next question is that only, that is dense air will descend. Dense air descends. Dense air, what happens? Descends. Dense air descends. Descends means what? It will be coming down. So option B, descends, is the answer for that question. Okay. And see here, due to this, the land and water also are having different variations. The land absorbs heat very fastly, whereas water absorbs heat very slowly. So there is a difference in the absorption of the heat and also release of the heat by both land and water. Here you have to identify the true statement. The first statement is land gets heated very fast. That is the right statement. So land gets heated very fast. That is the answer for this. Okay. And now, children, that is, you have 4 marks essay question. That is called as the drawing the picture of the planetary winds. Planetary winds picture you need to draw. You need to draw the planetary winds picture. See here, children. See here. That is 7th question. Planetary winds. The total world has... Different pressure zones. So alternatively, one area has a high pressure, the other area has a low pressure, like this. Alternative pressure zones are there in the world. You need to draw the pressure belts of the world. See here, children. The equator has a low pressure. So this is also having the low pressure. And just above that one, Tropic of Capricorn. And this particular area, the total area is having low pressure. So low pressure belt is there. And from here, the southeast trade winds will be moving. In the same manner, from this side, the northeast trade winds will be moving. Above that particular path, you have the subtropical high pressure belt. See, this is called as a subtropical high pressure belt. What is that? Subtropical high pressure belt. So this is low pressure now and this is high pressure. So from here onwards, this particular area is subpolar low pressure belts, and this is polar high pressure belt. So now what happens? From these subtropical high pressure belts, The winds will be moving to the low pressure belts, and we call them as the westerlies. And these winds that are moving from the polar high pressure to the subpolar low pressure, these are called as the polar winds. Or we call them as the easterlies. Like this, three different types of the winds are there. One is planetary winds, the trade winds, the trade winds. The trade winds will be moving in between the Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. That is from the subtropical high pressure belt to the equatorial low pressure belt. Subtropical high pressure belt to the equatorial low pressure belt. In the same manner, from the subtropical high pressure belt to the subpolar low pressure belt. These are called as a westerlies. From polar high pressure belt to subpolar, subpolar low pressure belt. These are called as the easterlies. This is all about the picture of the planetary winds. Tomorrow we'll meet with one more assignment key. Until then, children, have a good day and have a nice health. Thank you, children.